I'm just going to use a little bit of the black on the inner side of this layer stacks can to create a net contrast. So you have the blue and then you have the black. Just waiting for my gun to heat up so that I can begin mending this. So now we've got our textures. We've got elevated textures here, different levels. I'm just gonna let this, hopefully it's gonna come on shortly. Once this comes on, I'm gonna glue down this white for the crushing shores. Just gonna cut this up. No particular way, any kind of jagged cuts. will do. And while you wait, I can also cut up the sand or the scraps of fabric cloth that I found that we can use for our sand. It almost is the sand tone exactly, very much close to the brown for the cardboard. And again, I can randomly place this wherever. It doesn't matter, it can overlap. It can overlay, meaning one on top of the other. When you're doing this, you want to think kind of the beach scenery that you're working with. Because right now I'm cutting out the sand and I'm actually thinking about kind of like the grooves that I see in the sand. Like I'm just thinking about the grooves or the patterns that are made by the waves pushing on it. So I'm just kind of trying to create that exact same feel or that look. Good. And our gun is ready. And again, you can glue this part down any kind of way. It doesn't really matter how you glue it down. It can be random. Once you have the feel of a beach, you'll be good. Remember to use up every bits and pieces that you have. Don't allow anything to go to waste. Before I finish that, I can continue to glue down the rest of the blue because this is easier to finish for the waves. So I'm just gonna glue down this black and blue pattern that I have going on here. Finish black to the white part of the shore. All right, and I'm done with that. Now I'm just gonna go right back into my white. okay, now with this part, because of this kind of edge, because of this curvy jagged edge, I'm gonna kind of just cut the material to fit the exact edge. Okay, almost. Okay, I'm done with that. And I'm pleased. I think it looks nice. A few of my pieces are thrown away. I'm gonna have to cut some more. Now I'm just gonna put the cloth on that will resemble the sand. The interesting thing about this cloth is that I don't have to always cut. I can tear it as well, or I can scrunch it up just to fit the form of which I need it. So I'm getting the kind of patterns that I need inside of the sand. Just keep in mind to cover up these cardboard areas. Like we spoke about on Monday, you want to make sure you cover up as much as you can, as much as possible, just in case you don't have paint to go over it. You still want to cover up a lot of the cardboard areas with the scraps that you have. And thankfully, I got a lot of scraps so I can cover up the majority of my areas. Okay. Don't worry if you get little threads from the glue. You can always just peel them off, or you don't even have to worry about them. They still add to the overall piece. I see I have a lot of them in random areas, but they still will add to my overall piece. Now I'm just going to fold the cloth so that I can get into this kind of curved area. Once I'm done with this, if necessary, I'm going to just paint lightly over the sky in certain areas just to enhance the colors that I already have there. I already have yellows. You can see that. You can see I have reds, but I'll just paint some areas lightly so that I can enhance it. Because most of my found objects already did the job for me. Okay. Now I can look at the overall piece and see if there's any area I would like to touch up before I go to paint. I probably can put some more right here, some more of the blues right up in this area here where the cardboard is still exposed and right about there. Maybe some more blues right here, yeah, here. A little bit of black right here. If you're working with objects that are hard to cut, this is a good scissors, but a shears would also be good to cut objects that are a bit harder to cut. some objects won't stay in place when you glue it. So what I just did was to hold it down for a second or two, just so that it stays in place and the glue actually mends to the object. Or adheres to the object. So again, I'm just looking for the cardboard areas. I'm not gonna cover up everything. I already did that on Monday. So I'm just looking for all the brown areas that I still left exposed that I can just kind of cover over before I touch it with a little bit of paint. All right. Okay, I'm just going to touch the water area with the paint now. I'm going to use a plain blue. This one is Pathylo. Doesn't matter which glue you have, because the idea is that it's just supposed to mimic waves. You don't want it to be a Picasso. You just want it to look like water. So again, I'm using the Pathylo blue. I'm going to use my broadest brush, dip it in a little bit of water. and just getting all of those brown areas. It doesn't matter if it goes on the found objects. That's the idea. The idea is for it to go in all of those areas. Be careful of how you paint your blue around the white areas or around any opposite color, other color than the blue. Just gonna stop right there because I realized that one or two of my pieces weren't glued down. And quickly put a little bit of glue on it, stick it, and move on. For this technique, we're working with a little bit of wet brush. We don't want the brush to be dry. That's why I put water on it. We want it to glance or glide over the objects. You want it to be loose or fluid. Got a little bit of my blue on the yellow and I just wanted to wipe it off. Okay, I'm out of paint. For this, I didn't want to pour a huge amount because I don't want to waste anything. So I wanted to pour just as much as I think I would need. A small amount is always good, just so that you don't waste paint. So like I said, I'm only gonna paint the water for today. Just make sure I touch up all of the brown areas. Oh, sorry, and parts of the sky, because that is also blue. All right, and I am done. When we come back, what we're gonna do on Fridays, we're gonna continue painting into the sky. We're going to paint the red areas and the yellow areas. And then I'm going to show you guys how you can protect your piece once you're done and you want to keep it for a longer period of time. I'm going to show you what you can use to protect your piece. So this is my piece.